Welcome to this video. In this video, I will talk about the final year MBBS books to be read. Okay, so in this video, I will give you the subject-wise list of the books that is to be read during your final year professional exams. Okay, there are so many books out there, and it is not at all required to read all those books. Okay, I have given my exam and I have passed it very successfully with 70% of marks, okay, in my university exams, and I have also performed well in my clinics also. So I think I am the right person to advise you about the books which is to be read during your final year examination. Okay, what happens is many a time students are very much confused that which books to read, okay, because there are two types of books available. Okay, one type of book is the standard book and other the easy way out book. Okay, so I will help you to select from both of this category wisely and to, you know, clear your final year exams. So read only that is required. Okay, so with this motto we will start our video. So let's get started. So we have 365 days, 4 major subjects, 4 minor subjects, right, plus clinics, so it's like overwhelming. Okay, and I was also overwhelmed and confused when I entered my final year exam. Okay, so I was so much confused that I always, you know, browse and see which books to be read. I used to buy so many books, okay, and try to read from all that books, but at the end of the day only that much is to be required that is been asked in your exam. So read wisely. In this video I will talk about mainly what type of books that is to be required to be read. Okay, so for surgery, the standard book we have is Love and Bailey. Okay, that is the most standard book that is used worldwide, but what happens is this is a very large and a huge book. To read it during final year exam, it is difficult. I've already told you that we have 365 days, 4 major subjects, 4 minor subjects and clinics. Okay, so what happens is many a times we don't get much time to read. So the better option, okay, is Manipal, Manual of Surgery. This is very easy book to read, okay, easy to grasp the subject, and the information are written for a longer time. Then we have SRB Manual. This is mainly used by our PG resident, okay. Our seniors used to say that we use this, like our R1, R2, okay, who are working in surgery. They used to say that SRB is a very huge book, but frankly speaking, this is the best book if you have time and you are committed that you will read 10 hours a day, okay. For all those 365 days, then you can read this. Okay, what I recommend is you keep this Manipal Manual and SRB side by side, and what the topics which you are not able to understand from this Manipal, read it from SRB. Okay, otherwise main source should be the SRB to, you know, clear your exam. Our first motto when we are in final year is to clear our exam. Okay, if we are not able to clear our exam, then there is 6 months back, okay, and that will cost you a huge. Okay, so first thing that is to be in your brain is to clear my exam. Okay, this, there are so many books, there is so much to know. Our MBBS field is like, it's a never on, ending process. Okay, it's like an ocean, so you cannot you know, how much hard you try, even if you study for 24 hours straight for 365 days, I guarantee you will not able to complete, you know, all the standard books, and you cannot remember everything. So what is required, read that much only. Okay, and for clinics, you can go for SDAS. This is the most standard books and loved by our professors. Then you can also go for Makhanlal Shah, because in this what will happen is they will give you the like history, okay, the history we take, okay, it is like an history form format, so it will be very much helpful to you that how to present the history. So I recommend you buy both and keep this side by side for the exams. So yeah, next is a Pedia. For Pedia, the one and only book that is worldwide famous, that is Guy. And for practicals, you can go for Maharban Singh. This is also a good book. So for Pedia, there is no much confusion. Okay, so do this much, you will cover most of the things. Then in medicine we have this Bible of the medicine, okay, Harrison's, which every professor will recommend you. But think wisely. Again, I am saying 365 days, 4 major subjects, 4 minor subjects plus clinics. You won't be able to complete this Harrison, okay? If you are very studious and very nerdy, then you can start it from your, like, when you come enter the second year. So from second year, if you are committed and you start reading this book, then it will be easy for you to complete. I have my senior, there was one girl, she started reading Harrison's from her second year, okay? But she almost read everything, every major system. But at the end of the final year exam, she took this book and started reading from this to pass the exams. So this book is for professional exam, okay, to pass the exam. These are like for reference, you can read, okay? Again, I'm telling you, you have all time in the world. This 1 year has the focus is should be to pass your exam, okay? So if you want to buy it, okay, and if you love to buy it, then you can go for Harrison, or you go to a library of your college where you can find this and just refer, okay? Main symptoms, like I have read respiratory system from this. It is very good, you know, it is written very in a very good way, and it's like very high yielding for your exam. But you know, it's very time consuming. When I entered my second year, you know, I started reading Harrison, and I started from respiratory system, so I was able to complete it. But it was like, it took me 2 months to complete, okay? Because you know, we need to attend 9-to-5 college, then we have clinics, okay? And then a resident used to call us after 5 o'clock, okay? They used to teach us. So like, we reach 7 o'clock around at our place, okay? And very tired, and it's like very overwhelming process, everybody knows this. So you know, there were like, I used to get 3 to 4 hours to read, and so that's why it took me so long. But yeah, this is a good book if you want to read. Then we have Davidson. It is the best book, okay? If you are not able to read this Harrison, then you can go for this. But what I recommend is go for George Matthew from starting, okay? When you are okay, going through your terms, like it is like 2 months duration, and there is a ward living exam, okay? At that time, I recommend you to start just with George Matthew and keep both these books side by side if you want, okay? Otherwise, there is no need. Then practical exam, we have this book that is Golwala. Okay, I recommend you to read this during your postings. This is the best, one of the best books, okay, for the clinical examination, and how to go for systemic examination, general examination. And it is very much explained in detail, everything is given. So it is a good book to go for. Then for anesthesia, we have this short book that is Ajay Yadav. You know, during our times, I have not read this book, but this was recommended by our seniors. What we used to do is, we used to get this notes from our seniors. Okay, our senior has made this note, and we used to take notes from him. He was a boy, yeah. And we used to read from that. So if there are some kind of pamphlets you know, circulating in your college, then you can go for it, or otherwise this book is also good. So yeah, the next is dermatology. For this, Nina Khan is best, okay? You can go for this. Yeah, comparatively, so many informations are given, but only IMP topics is to be read during your final exams. Then for Ortho Maheshwari, this is best book, okay, very crisp and very informative also at the same time. So for Gynec, okay, Vio Datta. And for practical exams, you can go for Doshi. This is also a good book. So yeah, that's all for this video. I have mainly given you the list of the books that is to be required for the final prof exam. Please, 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 I recommend you don't go for more books, okay? It will only waste your time, because from, for example, you are reading RS, okay, you will read from Harrison, then you will read from Levitson, then you will read from George Matthew. This will take it, eat up your time, and that picture memory will won't be able to form. Okay, and during exams you will just confuse that from which book you have read, and it will be chaos at the end of the day. Okay, this has happened to me, that's why I'm telling you. Okay, go for those books which you think that, yeah, I will able to complete it. If you are good enough, and if you think that I can complete Harrison, okay, there is no loss in reading it. Then it is best if you can complete Harrison. It's like a Bible for medicine. Okay, if you read medicine from Harrison, then it means that you have got all the knowledge, okay, on the planet Earth about medicine. Okay, that has been researched out. So Matthew is also good. It is not that Matthew is like, if you read from Matthew, then your knowledge will be less. No, it's not like that. Matthew has written its notes from Harrison. Okay, but how he is writing is, he's only writing the important points. Okay, he will write important points and also in a notes form. Okay, so what will happen is, it will be very much easy for you to grasp the information, read it, understand it. And while you will, when you will read Harrison, what will happen is, there are so many paragraphs. Okay, and from every paragraph, there are 2 to 3 points that is to be remembered. Okay, other is explanation. So what this Matthew has done is, he has taken all these important points and compiled it into a book, that is George Matthew. Okay, so it is not that he has made his book by himself. He has also taken information from the standard books, and he has used many references also. He have given by the end of each chapter that he has used this so and so references. So yeah, so I advise you to read only that much which is required, okay, to pass the exam. It is very difficult, you know, this 1 year, it's like, it's very difficult to, it is the most difficult year, okay, of all those 5.5 years. It is very you know, a stressful year, I must say this, because I have experiences, and so I can share my experience with you. So to make it less stressful, I have listed the books here, and I will recommend, and I'm telling you to read only this much books. It is enough, okay? There is no need for reading all those, you know, 4 or 5 books for each and every topic. No, it's not required. So yeah, that's all for this video. And thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe and share. And I will come up with this type of videos soon. And if you like it, please do share and comment. Thanks for watching.